Well, you wanted me to talk about a bunch of things.
You begged me to be on the show, and I said no, and you said, please, I'll do anything.
What's the word you used to describe
me? You texted
me
at 2 a.m., and you said, I'm crying, please. There's nothing left in my life. Put me on the show.
Yeah.
And I exactly felt sorry for you. And
yeah. Okay. Yeah.
This is getting more ridiculous by the second. Hi, I'm Burke Collins.
And I'm Asim Hussain.
And this is a Dum Dum.
And this is a Dum Dum.
And this is 5 super secret special services for building single page applications. Get it?
I think you got it. I think you nailed it.
Nailed it.
Yeah.
Thing number one, static storage. What do you mean by static storage? What kind of a service is that exactly?
So a static storage solution like Azure Blob Storage, what it does is it's optimized for returning a static asset. Right.
So that's what it's really good at. It's just returning
really
that one thing.
Yeah.
And a single page application is really just a static asset.
Yeah. I mean, if you look at a single page application, one that's built in Angular or Vue or React or anything like that, if you look at the end product, it's just a folder with a bunch of files inside it. And that's it.
Right. So you don't really need a whole elaborate web server setup to serve a single page application. And in fact, it might be faster. It's probably faster.
It's a lot faster.
It's a lot faster to serve it from static storage to something like Azure Blob Storage.
Exactly, right? All they're doing is it's reading a file from a disk and it's sending it right back out. Easy.
Sounds simple to me.
And it's cheaper.
Thing number two, you should really consider using a CDN or a content delivery network. Now this one's strange for me because I thought CDNs were for serving up copies of jQuery. Why do I need a CDN for my single page application? What do I get out of it if it's already on static or blob storage?
Well, a CDN, what a CDN does is it creates copies of your resources on different nodes all over the world. So for instance, if your static storage solution is in the US and you have got a CDN in front of it, there might be a CDN with copies of your data in Japan, in India, in Australia, all over the world. So then when you've got a Japanese customer who's visiting your website, they'll get served from the Japanese computer, which is kind of much closer to them, so it's much, much faster.
So this is all about speed.
It's all about speed,
and
yeah,
getting
yeah.
your files as close to the customer as possible and cached and ready to go, so when they make the request, it's just right there outside their front door.
That's it, yeah.
Sounds amazing.
Yeah.
Thing number three, you should seriously consider serverless functions. Serverless is a buzzword. I feel like we just say serverless and it's like magic. Nobody knows what it does. They just know how to use it in a blog post.
That's exactly what it is.
Why should I use serverless functions with my single page application? What's the benefit to me?
Well, normally with a single page application, you'll need to have an API somewhere. You need to have
like an Express or a .NET, some sort of data access layer.
Yeah. You need to store some data in a server and get access to it, right?
So
normally create an API. Normally serve that on a server somewhere and just have that hosted somewhere. But you can just use serverless functions, which allow you to just write an API directly against the database on something like Azure Functions.
So you don't need a whole web framework runtime, really.
Not at
you
all.
Just need to write the code.
Yeah.
And all of that's already hosted in the serverless. Yeah.
But the really, really cool thing about serverless functions and static storage, I have to say as well, is that they scale automatically for you, right? So you can get 0 calls, you won't scale out at all. If you get 10,000 calls, it'll scale out for you automatically.
So when my app goes to the front page of Hacker News, no problem, it just
when
scales out.
When it goes to the front page of Hacker News.
When, because anything that I write
of
is
course.
Going to the front page of Hacker News, like this episode of 5 Things. It's also super cheap,
we
should note. It's like pennies, and this is what you want when it's low load, you want to pay nothing, and when it's high load, you still want to pay nothing, not as much. So you're only paying for the compute that you use.
Exactly.
And not wasting.
I would describe it as if you get 0 hits, you pay 0, right?
Which is exactly what we want.
But you're never going to get 0 hits.
I
won't get 0 hits.
Even with serverless, I'm paying a fortune.
You won't get 0 hits.
No. Well, you might. You might.
I might.
Well, you don't know about
you
this
definitely
person.
Won't.
You actually look really good, man.
Normally
you look terrible.
Today.
Oh, did you?
I took a picture of it. I shaved. I ironed a shirt.
That's true. Your beard looks less substantial.
Yeah,
usually
it's
not as pointy. You rounded it off.
No, I didn't round it off. No. I shaved. I was walking out the door and I was like,
oh, yeah, you shaved it into like a
line. Yeah, I cleared out the hair and stuff.
I like that. You should do something about the eyebrows, though. That's a connect with your hairline. That's so mean. Thing number four, you really need to have some sort of tool for your spa that handles workflow or automation type activities. And these are things that are not covered by your API, but still need to happen on the server. Can you give me an example of what exactly that means, or what are some of the different services that we can use to do that?
Well, what it kind of means is back in the day, before the SPA days, before the SPA days, we would normally kind of put like a cron job on a server and have something running on the server side, right? We need something to do that right now with our SPAs. And what we've got on Azure is called Azure Logic Apps. If you're using something else, you can use like IFTTT or Zappy or something like that. But essentially, functionality that runs without a user needing to click a button or make an API request.
So what's an example of someplace where I might use a Logic App in a single page application? What's a use case for that?
Well, a whole bunch of use cases. Anytime you need to do any kind of workflow management of your application, I might use a Logic App which batches up all of the emails I need to send and processes them every hour. I might have another Logic App which I need to listen to Twitter to see if anybody has tagged me and then perform some activity, save something to a database, have a Logic App for that. These are the kind of things which you wouldn't handle with an API request because they're not user triggered.
So instead of having like a sysadmin that sits about there clicking a button every hour to do something, I guess that's where the Logic Apps would come in, and you would just schedule those sorts of things down.
Exactly. That's perfect. Perfect example.
And you don't have to write a lot of code, at least with Logic Apps, to do that. You just drag blocks out, and they connect together. I like blocks.
Yeah,
blocks I can
UIs.
Do. It's like Legos.
Yeah.
Everybody loves it's actually Lego. It's not Legos.
It's
for all
it's
you Lego Legos. Pedantics.
Legos.
Yeah, it's definitely not Legos. No, they say Legos?
In the UK, we say Legos.
That's just wrong.
You're saying wrong.
This interview's over. Thing number five, you definitely need some sort of continuous integration tool. What exactly is a continuous integration tool, and why is it helpful for a single page application?
Well, I think it's helpful for a lot of different types of applications, but it's helpful for us, especially when you work with more than one person. Right? If you're working on yourself, you might just bring up VS Code and deploy manually from there. But when you work with multiple people, with GitHub or something like that, it's really useful to have something where if you check into master or you merge into master, it auto-deploys your site for you. And also to have something like PR validation. We all want it. So when you create a PR on my code, then it will do a validation. Maybe it will run an NPM install, maybe an NPM build, an audit, or a test, or something like that, just to make sure that your code is okay.
My code's always okay.
Yeah, so it's good. I mean,
so for us, we have Azure DevOps, and we actually use this on the VSCodeCanDoThat.com site. There's a blog post in the show links below that you can check out. It shows how we set this up.
Yeah.
But we pull in a Docker container. We run NPM install. We run NPM build, which builds the Vue project. Every time someone checks into master, it's like it just, like magic.
Magically.
It just happens.
Yeah.
And we don't have
to worry
about it. Yeah. It really is an amazing thing.
Jinx.
You owe me one soda. Actually, I prefer a seltzer water.
A seltzer water?
Yeah.
And
not just any LaCroix? Yeah, LaCroix in the UK?
I don't know what that is.
It's a delicious seltzer water. But here
salty
at Microsoft,
water.
We have Talking Rain. It's called Talking Rain.
Talking Rain.
Yeah.
And again, it's salty water.
Seltzer water.
Seltzer water.
Nobody drinks salt.
I don't know.
It's salty water.
Okay.
I would like a salty water.
I'll get you a salty water.
Thank you. Yeah. I'm Burke Holland.
I don't know what to say.
I'm Burke Holland.
And I'm Burke Holland.
I'm Burke Collins.
And I'm Asim Hussain.
And now you know five super secret special services for building single page applications.
Oh, yeah.
Americans are drinking salty water.
What is seltzer water? What
seltzer
is that?
Seltzer water, it's just like a carbonated water, but with no flavor. There's no sugar.
So it's sparkling water.
Sparkling water. And an Italian soda, sometimes they call it Italian soda. You heard
this
Italian soda?
I bet it's just because it's fancy.
Yeah, we think the Italians
fancy.
Are fancy. Are the Italians fancy?
Oh, they're pretty fancy, actually.